absolutely naked girls, absolutely in marble, flesh color marble, in the Holy of Holies, they have wings. That's the only thing. Otherwise, naked, you can see the breast, the nipples, and the buttocks. And if you fondle the buttocks, millions of hands have gone over the buttocks. From the sheen on that marble, you can make out that everybody passes by wants to feel that marble. And there's a sheen, you know, this type of shine on the marble will give you an electric shock if you touch it. God Almighty, imagine, is riding these things, these young girls, young Christians. He didn't know about a helicopter, this God of ours. You know, he didn't know about a flying saucer. No. He's riding little girls. What are you doing? What a mockery you are making of God. This is what hurts the Muslim. You are making a mockery of God. You say, and God told you this? He's telling you, right, little girls, naked girls. Shame. It's a shameful thing. And the Arab Christian has the audacity. Arab Christian. Ishaq Ibrahim. He wrote a book called Black Gold and Holy War. This is telling the Americans how best to fix up, you know, tighten the screw on the Arabs. He's an Arab. His name is Ishaq Ibrahim. And in this book, he's giving ideas to the Americans and the Western nations how to tighten the screw on the Arab. But, by the way, he's describing in the book, Allah Bari Ta'ala. God Almighty, he's describing Allah. This Christian, Arab, is describing Allah because of the ideas he has got from his book. He says, I'm reading, page 70, the Muslim's view of God is that of an elderly cherubic Arab. You know, elderly but little baby like God, Allah. This was cherubic. Where did he got it from? He got it from the Holy Bible. You know, God Almighty, in this book, if it is the book of God, he seems to have a special predilection, preferential partiality for the Palestinians. Special place he has for the Palestinians in his book, this Bible. That the Palestinians can be used not for cannon fodder, but for foreskin fodder. Ever heard of it? I read it for you. 1 Samuel, book of Samuel, chapter 18, verse 27. It says here, therefore David arose and went, he and his men, Dawud alayhi salam, David, and killed 200 Palestinians. And David brought the foreskins. You know, when you do khatna, circumcision, that skin which you throw away, very valuable. Don't throw it away. It might be used for currency. When you go back to Israel one day, when you conquer that country, it might be used for currency, same currency that David used. Listen. He killed 200 Palestinians, Philistines. And David brought the foreskins and they gave them in full count. Full count. He counted out. 1, 2, 3. You know, like 1 pound, 2 pound, 3 pounds. He counted out 200 cash foreskins to get a wife, a princess. You know, Saul's daughter, Michelle. He paid out in foreskins of the Palestinians, was used for currency. Cheap currency, 200. Chip. He counted them out. And God Almighty, some special liking, I said, I don't know what type of thing, loves them so much, the Palestinians. And Moses, I'm reading from the book of Numbers, chapter 31, verses 15, 17, and 18. And Moses said to them, have you kept all the women alive? All the women, you have kept them alive? Now therefore, kill every male among the little ones. Every male child among the little ones of the Palestinians, kill them. And kill every woman who has known man intimately. If any woman has ever had sex with a man, kill them also. But keep alive for yourselves, all the young girls, not the little ones. Little ones is a liability. You got to feed them and bring them up. No time for that. But keep alive for yourselves, all the young girls, the Palestinian young girls, who have not known a man intimately. This is the instruction given to Jewish soldiers in the field. Now, when they see a young Palestinian girl, how can you verify whether this woman has experienced sex or not? How do you verify? The soldier in the field, he doesn't know about the saliva test. He doesn't know anything about it. The only way is to rape and ravish these Palestinian girls to verify whether a man has been through her or not. And if they discover that she has already been used secondhand, chop off her head. If not, keep them. And they saved for themselves 32,000 Palestinian girls whom no man had known. After raping and ravishing them, they saved for themselves 32,000 for themselves. And out of that, the Lord Almighty, God Almighty, must also have his pound of flesh. So it says, and 32 was for the Lord. I am asking, what does the Lord do with, what does he do with 32 raped and ravished Palestinian girls? You tell me. In a book of God, God giving instructions that you go along and you verify. God talking this, filth and dirt, kill every little child, male and female, kill them all. Only young girls you must keep. And they too, one that know, they have not known man sexually. Now, if you believe, I'm asking, my dear brother Sharosh, you believe this Jewish folklore? You believe? Of course, he does. What happens? What happens? It changes your mentality. So he writes in his book, Jesus, Prophecy and the Middle East, page 80. It's a strange thing to him that the Arabs are fighting for Palestine. It's a strange thing. He says, I'm quoting him, let me quote, that the Arabs control 3 million square miles of land, but cannot allow Israel, their kinfolk. Ask the Jew whether he considers you as his kinfolk. Their kinfolk, to have 10,000 square miles, that's all, only 10,000 square miles. The hallowed parcel of land, Palestine, has actually been in the hands of the Arab people longer than it has been controlled by the descendants of Jacob, yet God promised it to this Jew. He believes that God promised it to the Jew. And he says here, not 10,000. Now he says, page 61 of the same book, he says, in fact, according to Genesis 15:18 and Jeremiah 23:7-8, the promise will eventually cover 180,000 square miles. From the river Nile to the Euphrates, he's prepared to give it to them. He's given it to them. What did it? That Shamgar's stick and Samson's jawbone did the job. See, psychology, it does it. Then what about southern Lebanon? On page 6085 it says, what about Israel's invasion of Lebanon in June 1982? Brother Sharosh says, actually, southern Lebanon is prophetically considered a part of greater Israel. So what are you worried about then? What are you crying for? You Lebanese people, you Arabs, what are you worried about? It's all promised to the Jews. Give it to them. He cries crocodile tears in his book, Liberated Palestinian. He cries, say, over 2 million of my people are suffering. I'm quoting. He said, over 2 million of my people are suffering. Many are bitter, sick, and lonely. Some have been in refugee camps for over 35 years. Now, over 40 years. And more, his father has been killed by the Jews. His cousin was killed by the Jews. But what is the end result of all this? His people are suffering, he says. They are bitter and sick and lonely, he says. He's crying crocodile tears for them. So now he says, so, and he supports, page 175, and he supports a small